of Danielle and Freddie. We are gathered here on this special day to witness their union in holy matrimony. This is a great celebration and reverence on which we come together before God to recognize and commemorate the sacred love and dedication shared between these two people. It is wonderful to have friends and family to join us here today. The bride and groom would like to thank each of their guests for being here, and would like you to know that each of you had played an integral part of their intertwining lives. As the Bible reminds us in Corinthians, love is patient, love is kind. It does not envy, it does not boast. It is not proud. It is not rude, it is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered, and it keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, and always perseveres. Love never fails. In the time that Danielle and Freddie have spent together, they've built the sturdy foundation for a lifelong relationship. And after a great deal of thoughtful consideration, they have decided to bind themselves to one another for the rest of their lives. May you all remember and cherish this ceremony, for on this day, with love, we will bind Danielle and Freddie together. Marriage is a sacred ceremony. Today we observe the union of these two people with respect and great joy. Marrying a shared life is a tremendous blessing. And now, as Danielle and Freddie embark on this journey together, they will be able to nurture a love that will make them better versions of themselves. Marriage is indeed the perfect garden from which to sow and harvest personal growth. Danielle and Freddie learn to work together, to laugh together, and to love together. Don't get caught up in worldly things that will draw you apart. Instead, focus on your shared devotion. As your relationship strengthens, you will find that you come to share a remarkable love, a love that is both abundantly given and freely accepted. Now, as our bride and groom prepared for the ceremony today, they reflected on what it is that they love about each other. And now they'd like to share that with you. So we're going to start with Danielle.
Oh, I actually wrote it down. She's old-fashioned.
Okay. I choose you to be my husband, my partner in life. I promise you my unconditional love, my fullest devotion, my most tender care. Through the pressures of the present and the uncertainties of the future, I promise to love you, honor, respect, and cherish you all the days of our lives. You and our children are my everything. At this moment, I feel that all of my prayers have been answered. I know that our love is heaven sent, and I promise to be here forever and always.
Danielle, in your eyes, I have found my home. In your heart, I have found my love. In your soul, I have found my love. With you, I am whole, full and alive. You make me laugh, you let me cry. You are my breath, my every heartbeat. I pledge to listen to your advice and occasionally take it. I pledge to never take score, even when I'm totally winning. I pledge to you always and admire your huge, strong, and kind and determined heart. You know me better than anyone else, and somehow still you manage to love me. You are my best friend and my wonderful mother to our beautiful children, my one true love. There is still a part of me today that cannot believe that I'm the one who gets to marry you. I love you.
And now we're going to have an exchange of vows. We're going to start with Danielle, and you're going to repeat after me. I, Danielle, take you, Freddie, for my lawfully wedded husband.
I, Danielle, take you, Freddie, for my lawfully wedded husband.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
For better or worse.
For better or worse.
For richer or poor. I promise to be true to you in good times and bad.
I promise to be true to you in good times and bad.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
I will love and honor you all the days of my life.
I will love and honor you all the days of my life.
Until death do us part.
Until death do us part.
This is my solemn vow.
This is my solemn vow.
And now, Freddie, you're going to hear the table. I, Freddie, take you, Danielle, for my lawfully wedded wife.
I, Freddie, take you, Danielle, as my lawfully wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or worse, for richer or poorer.
For better or worse, for richer or poorer.
I promise to be true to you in good times and bad.
I promise to be true to you in good times and bad.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
I will love and honor you all the days of my life.
I will love and honor you all the days of my life.
Until death do us part.
Until death do us part.
This is my solemn vow.
This is my solemn vow.
Do you, Danielle, take Freddie to be your lawfully wedded husband? Do you promise to honor him in love, to be sensitive to his needs, to comfort him in difficulty, and to put your full and complete trust in him as long as you both shall live? Say, I do.
I do.
Do you, Freddie, take Danielle to be your lawfully wedded wife? Do you promise to honor her in love, to be sensitive to her needs, to comfort her in difficulty, and to put your full and complete trust in her as long as you both shall live?
I do.
And now we're going to have an exchange of rings. To commemorate this union, you may now exchange rings. The circle formed by each symbolizes your external love and commitment to one another. Let these rings always remind of that love and the promises that were made here today. So, you can put your finger. I give you this ring as a symbol of my love and commitment.
I give you this ring as a symbol of my love and commitment.
With this ring, I be wed.
With this ring, I be wed.
I give you this ring as a symbol of my love and commitment.
I give you this ring as a symbol of my love and commitment.
With this ring, I be wed.
With this ring, I be wed.
By the power vested in me by the state of New Jersey, I now pronounce you husband and wife. And now, ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the new Mr. and Mrs. Santiago.